to call 911. Police found the woman dead. The boyfriend later turned himself in and remains in custody at this hour. It's the opening day that didn't happen, but take a look at this. Some diehard fans still trying to enjoy the occasion. You're looking at a live picture from near Comerica Park where the tailgating didn't end just because the game was called. It is the first time ever that a home opener has been canceled at Comerica Park. Tigers were supposed to play the Pittsburgh Pirates this afternoon. Thousands of fans still travel downtown to celebrate the beginning of baseball season. They probably had fun, but they didn't see any baseball. Some are continuing to celebrate at this hour, while others had to pack up their parties.
They're telling us we have to get out of here because they don't want to be responsible for anything, but everybody has to leave. We spent all this time setting up, and now here we are taking down.
We're a little disappointed that the game may be over, but the tailgate doesn't have to be over.
Oh, gotta love those Tigers fans. The game has been rescheduled for tomorrow at 1:10 in the afternoon. All tickets from today's game will be valid tomorrow as well, or they can be exchanged for any future regular season game in the next 12 months. Well, Ben, you were right. You did say that you thought that was going to happen. So, will the second time be the charm? Are we going to be able to have baseball tomorrow?
I think so. It looks like we'll be able to squeeze one in tomorrow. Saturday's game could be another question, but we got to get through tonight's commute first. Steady rain downtown Detroit, and they were right. There's no reason to be having that game this afternoon because these showers only increasing in intensity as we get closer to the cold front a little bit later on this evening. Plenty of rain down there in Detroit and Wayne County. But most of our north and west zones coming up dry right now, especially north of 69. There's not much going on in there, so all that rain can find about the southern half of the area, at least on the diagonal. And speaking of that, temperatures falling from the mid-40s to the upper 30s. We'll probably see that rain shut off just before 10 o'clock, at least area-wide. We'll talk about the possibility of getting that second game in on Saturday and also look at your Easter weekend forecast in just minutes. Okay.
We're learning more about these two women and their six adopted children. They're all at the center of a pretty confusing family tragedy on the West Coast. Five family members are dead. Three are missing. Dennis Gillian is in the newsroom tracking the very latest, and Devin investigators have a lot of questions in this case.
It is a little confusing, Karen. We'll dig into why here, but let's start with neighbors in Washington State who described this married couple, Jennifer and Sarah Hart, as loving, inspiring parents who promoted social justice and say they will be missed after their SUV plunged off a scenic California highway along the Pacific Coast. Investigators say the two women and